Hello, hello! It's CEO here. And in today's video, I'll be showing you how to unlock KK Slider. Having this Animal Crossing icon visit your island is not a piece of cake. So today, I'll show you the entire process of getting KK Slider to come visit your island and perform concerts every Saturday. But before we get into the video, a huge thank you to Disney Emoji Blitz for sponsoring today's video. You can download the game for free using the link in the description on your mobile device or tablet. I'm also giving away a $70 Nintendo eShop gift card, so stay tuned to the end to find out how to win. Disney Emoji Blitz is unlike any other Match 3 game on the market. Each emoji has its own unique power-up and you can control which one to use, offering a strong layer of strategy for each game you play. My favorite emoji has to be Sully from Monsters, Inc. because not only is he so cute, but he offers a special power-up to scare random emojis off the board, helping you get that high score. Disney Emoji Blitz offers a huge collection of Disney, Pixar, and Star Wars characters with new characters added every week. There is also a variety of emoji categories, including silver, gold, rainbow exclusive, as well as story and villain emojis. The emojis you earn in-game can also be used to send to your friends. And to sweeten this even more, I will be giving away a $70 Nintendo eShop gift card to one lucky viewer. To enter to win, you must download Disney Emoji Blitz using my link in the description, play the game, and screenshot when you get to level 10, then post the picture on Instagram or Twitter and tag me in it so I can see the post. The winner will be picked in 1 month from today, and I will announce who wins in a YouTube community post and in the description of this video. So be sure you're subscribed to my channel so you don't miss out. And last but not least, exclusively for this video, I will be giving away 4 exclusive emojis you can use in Disney Emoji Blitz. If you download the game using my link in the description, 3 random winners will receive Cinderella, Aurora, Tiana, and Meg emojis to use in the game. There is a link to a Google form with full details in the description below. This link also serves as a creator code, so anything you buy in the game helps support me and is greatly appreciated. Again, thank you to Disney Emoji Blitz for sponsoring this video. Now let's get into the video and get KK Slider onto our islands. In order to show you the complete process of getting KK Slider onto your island, I'm going to be starting a brand new Animal Crossing island. I'll be naming this island Blitz after today's sponsor of this video. So basically, what I need to do to get KK Slider to move onto my island and for him to visit any of your islands, you have to get your island to 3 stars. Now this entails playing the entire tutorial of Animal Crossing New Horizons. The game really doesn't start until you get KK Slider, so I will be showing you the fastest way to get through this tutorial in order to get the 3 stars. A smaller goal you can look at for getting KK Slider to move to your island is to unlock the Resident Services building, because you need Isabelle in order to unlock island evaluations. As I said earlier, you need to have a 3-star island for KK Slider to come visit your island, and you can't unlock the evaluation system until you have Isabelle in the Resident Services building. So what I'll be doing in the beginning of this video is concentrating on getting that building built and on my island. I also want to mention that I will be borrowing items and bells from my other Animal Crossing islands so I can make this process go faster. So basically, the first steps you need to do is build your tent. You'll want to be talking to Tom Nook periodically to see what he wants you to do so you can progress through the tutorial. Once you get to the point where you name your island, you'll want to go talk to Tom Nook and get your cot so you can go back in your tent and go to sleep. After you go to sleep, you'll wake up the next day and now you can really start unlocking KK Slider. And look, even after you fall asleep, you'll have a dream about KK Slider. It's like he knows I'm making this video. All right, KK Slider, thank you for all that great life advice, and now we'll continue to getting you onto our islands. So as I mentioned, you'll want to just go through all the dialogue with Tom Nook and periodically check with him in the Resident Services tent to see what he wants you to do. You're going to want to take his DIY workshop and then progress to get those Nook miles you'll need to pay off your first loan. There's a lot of ways you can do this, and I even made an entire video on the fastest way to pay off your first debt to Tom Nook. I show you how to get 5,000 Nook miles pretty fast and easily, and that video will be linked in the description down below, and an iCard will pop up that can take you to that video. Basically, you'll want to sell a lot of things, harvest pears, harvest things to sell, talk to your neighbors, go fishing, typical Animal Crossing activities. One of the funnest things you can do to unlock more Nook Miles is to make a custom design. Here, I'm making my favorite Disney Emoji Blitz emoji, Sully. I love how cute he turned out, and I will be using him for my flag later in this video. For the purposes of this video, I do want to unlock Blather's tent. Not the full museum yet, but just his tent. And you do this by giving creatures to Tom Nook in the Resident Services tent. You won't be able to unlock the Resident Services building unless you already have Blather's tent set up on your island, so you will want to pursue that with Tom Nook to get Blather's to visit your island and set up shop in his tent. You will need to unlock Nook's Cranny in order to progress far enough to get the Resident Services building. You do that by buying items from Timmy. Once you buy enough items, he will ask you about building a shop. You'll then have to collect materials for him to build the shop, give them over, then you'll be able to set up the shop with the construction kit, and the next day, you will have a Nook's Cranny on your island. I did pay off my first loan, but there also is no need to pay off the further loans on your house or even upgrade your house to get the Resident Services building. I'm also making sure to buy some items from Nook Shopping so I can start to decorate my island. Decorating is key to getting 3 stars. You must decorate little areas around your island for your evaluation rating to go up. This is crucial for getting KK Slider to come visit. Later in the video, you'll see that Tom Nook even talks about a special project to get KK Slider onto your island that requires you to decorate. But I'll go more into that later in this video. So we have Nook's Cranny all set up and ready to go. Perfect, perfect. Now I can start buying more items to decorate my island with. Mabel also came to visit in Nook's Cranny. You will also need to have the Able shop, and this means you will need to have the Able Sister shop set up on your island in order to unlock the Resident Services building. So once you unlock Nook's Cranny, you'll go in, you'll talk to Mabel, and then she'll mention how she's going to start visiting your island. Every time she visits your island, you must talk to her and buy at least one item from her. This will ensure that you can then unlock the official Able Sister shop. Progressing through the tutorial in Animal Crossing does take a bit of time. In total, I spent about 8 days in the game unlocking all of these things. So about over a week if you don't want to time travel. You will get to a certain point in the game where you'll talk to Tom Nook and he wants to build more houses on the island to have more villagers move onto the island. Before you can do that, he will say you need to build a bridge. Progress through building the bridge, get all the materials, make the construction kit for the bridge, which is a DIY in this case. Set up the bridge construction kit and then you'll be ready to go. You'll also want to be collecting sea creatures and bugs during this whole time so you can give them to Tom Nook, and once you give him 10 creatures total, he will say Blathers wants to come and set up shop on the island. Get that kit from Tom Nook, set up the construction plot, and you'll be good to go. If you want to get the pole vault, you'll need to go into the tent and talk to Blathers, but I was able to unlock KK Slider without ever going into Blathers' tent. I didn't need the vaulting pole, but if you want to get the vaulting pole, that's one extra step you can do. It's totally optional. It will make this process a little easier, so I do recommend doing it. After you build the bridge and you set up Blathers' tent, Nook will ask you to find locations to set up 3 more housing plots for potential villagers to come live in. If you get to this point where Nook asks you to build these construction plots, you are on the right track. If you're not sure if you're at the point yet where Nook will ask you to build these housing plots, you can always go talk to him in the Resident Services tent and ask, "What should I do?" With these housing kits, you can place them anywhere on your island, and then you will need to collect 6 pieces of furniture for each plot, for a total of 18 pieces of furniture. All of these are DIY based, so you will be able to go out onto your island and find the necessary materials you'll need to make these DIYs. Also, if you're missing any DIYs, Nook will give them to you, and you can get additional DIYs you may need from Nook's Cranny and from the kiosk in the Resident Services tent. For these 3 housing kits, you will need to have a lot of room around the whole plot that the game requires, because you will need to place furniture in the vicinity of the plot. Now that I have the 3 housing kits set up, I also have the bridge construction kit set up, and I have Blather's tent in construction as well, I can now move on to the next day. Yay, we now have Mabel visiting the island for the first time. This is great. This means we are 1 step closer to getting the Resident Services building and having KK Slider visit. I do recommend that when you're in the game to build the ladder as soon as you can, because having the ladder will help you in the future as you go along with this process. And now here I am collecting all the items I need for these 3 housing plots. 18 items is kind of a lot, but again, I was borrowing items from other islands. And once you have all the items, you're going to want to put the exterior items placed outside the plot and then submit into the box the 3 interior items. And you don't have to submit everything at once like I'm doing here. You can submit 1 item at a time. I highly recommend just waiting until you have everything to submit, but you don't have to do it that way. Nook always includes at least 1 flower wreath that you need to construct for the housing plots. But to do that, you will need to be able to cross your river, which you can do with the bridge, and you will need the ladder to climb up to the cliffs and pick some flowers. Luckily, the wreath is always made out of your native flower, so you don't have to worry about not having the correct flower. I guarantee your island will have all the necessary resources you will need to build all the items for these plots. The game is just basically trying to get you oriented with the whole island and trying to show you the ways to play Animal Crossing. Alright, so I placed and submitted every item I needed for the three housing plots, and now I just go back to Tom Nook and see what else he wants me to do. So he gave me 50 pieces of simple wooden fencing, and this is great. This is exactly what we want, because you will need to decorate your island in order to get to that 3-star rating. The key to getting a 3-star rating at this point is now flowers, fences, and decorating, and also villagers. So with these fencing pieces, Nook is basically trying to get you to start decorating the island. I'll continue decorating in a bit, but first we need to talk to Mabel, because without Mabel, without talking to her, we won't get the Able Sister shop and we will not get to that resident services building and we won't get to 3 stars. So I'm just gonna peruse what she has to offer for sale and just buy something, and that's pretty simple. I'm also gonna change up my villager look real quick, so it looks like the typical CEO villager. I don't really like the short hairstyle, so here I am just using the wooden mirror to get my long, luscious Animal Crossing hair so I look a little more like myself. Also, earlier on the island, I did go ahead and pick all the weeds because they do negatively contribute to your island rating. I went ahead and just picked all the weeds just to get them out of the way. All right, it's a new day. It's raining and stinky. Really should not have the umbrella so he can finally get unstinky. But nevertheless, let's get into the next day. And we have Leaf here. You don't have to interact with Leaf at all to unlock KK Slider, but I do advise you go to Leaf and buy additional flowers and pumpkins and bushes from him, because all those plants will help so much for getting up to that 3-star evaluation. So on this day, I did start to decorate. I made a little pumpkin patch. When you're thinking about decorating, a tip I use is just think of little areas that I want to have on my island. It definitely gives you some direction when you're just in the beginning stages of the game and you really don't know what to do. I also went ahead and planted a bunch of flowers around my town plaza. Now I'm building a fence. This is just to get those island points up. You can always undo the decorating you've done before if you don't like it, if you're just doing it to get to those 3 stars. Nothing is permanent, but you will want to place something down at this point to get to those 3 stars. I also do have the 3 villager plots that are open and are waiting to get villagers to move into them. A new villager will move into the plot once per day, so each plot should get filled each day you go into the future. All right, this is me decorating. You have to decorate in order to get your island valuation up. So here I'm decorating a little beach area. I wanted sort of like a birch wood themed little pink flowered themed beach. I think it came out really cute just using some of my favorite items. I know you probably don't have this many items as I have in your game if you're starting from the beginning. You can always just go into Nooks and buy literally whatever they have and place it. It doesn't have to look pretty. The game does not care how well put together a decorated area is. The game is simply counting how many placed items are on the ground. So you can definitely cheat the system and just put a whole bunch of placed items on the ground. I do want to note, dropped items will count negatively towards your score, so don't drop any items and plant flowers, bushes, pumpkins, trees, stuff like that. All right, and now I am going ahead and planting some more flowers around the town. I also advise you to not cut down every tree on your island right away. You will need trees for your island evaluation, so I'm just cutting down the trees that are in the way. Also, Nook will start to offer a DIY customization workshop. It is needed to progress further into the game. All right, it's a new day. Let's go see what Tom Nook has for us to do. Oh, he has no more advice to give us. All right, once you get to the point in the resident services tent, Nook says he has nothing else for you to do. This is where you're going to want to start focusing mainly on decorating and getting villagers to move on to your island. So I'm just gonna go in Nook's cranny, buy some more stuff, continue decorating around the island. I did get a little stuck at this point, so you may get stuck here as well, but nevertheless, I will tell you how to get unstuck. The reason Nook is saying he has nothing else for you to do is because you have to wait until all 3 villager plots are sold. Once all of them are sold and all the villagers have moved in, you will be able to progress in the game. All right, now that we're kind of at a stopping place in the game, I'm going to move on to the next day, and hopefully Tom Nook has more things for me to do. All right, perfect. Now that we had the last villager plot sold yesterday, today Nook is saying that resident services is finally upgrading. This is exactly what we want. We want that physical resident services building because that's where we'll have Isabelle, which means we can finally access our island evaluation. On this day, I also decided to pick up all the weeds on the outskirts of my island. Weeds do negatively count towards your island evaluation. All right, there wasn't much to do on this day because Nook didn't have any more advice for us, and he did announce that resident services was upgrading, so I just went ahead to the next day. Here we can see that the building is now under construction. And we have Mabel. This is perfect. The day where resident services is under construction, there is not much to do. I am going to go talk to Mabel. I also went ahead and started decorating more of the villager houses. And now we're going to move on to the next day. All right, this is amazing. We now have the resident services building. This is just what we want. We also have Mabel for the third time, which means we are about to get the Able Sister shop. Now that we have resident services building, we are now introduced to Isabel. We just want to focus on decorating and moving more villagers in, talking to Mabel, all the good stuff. Mabel gave us a construction kit, so we'll place her shop somewhere on the island. Now that we do have the physical resident services building, Tom Nook is introducing us to his plan to get KK Slider onto the island. This entire time, we have had our own agenda to get KK Slider onto the island, but once Tom Nook starts to talk about it, that means we are very, very close. Tom Nook will talk about how we need more visitors to come to the island in order to get KK Slider here. So he will offer to build a campsite. You will want to build this campsite. He'll give you the kit. You'll just have to go and place it somewhere on your island, and then we're good to go. I did want to go and check Isabel and see if we can access the island evaluations now. You actually can't. You will be able to access the island evaluation ratings with Isabel after a certain point. You can't access it right away. So I just keep checking every day until I see it. But this is the menu where you will check your island evaluation with Isabel. All right, I'm just gonna set the town flag and change the town tune because those are always good to have if you're trying to get a higher rating. All right, got the tailor shop set up. We're so close. And that's all I'm gonna do on this day. I have not gotten the ability yet to sell land from Nook. So most of the decorating you want on your island so far, you're going to want to focus on getting more villagers to move onto your island. This does start with the campsite. The second day you have the campsite, you will have a campsite villager. And here we have the ale shop is being built. This is perfect, just what we want. And we'll go to the next day because there's not much else to do on this day. So our island is looking a little more developed. I went ahead and decorated the Able Sister shop. All right, so we have our first campsite villager. Well, I was not expecting that. The rarest villager in the game has blessed our campsite, Raymond. So it looks like I will be having to move Raymond onto my island because you have to move in the first campsite villager you get. On this day, we are now able to talk to Nook and sell some land. You will need to pay 10,000 bells per plot, but you will need to do this in order to get KK Slider. And you can sell all the plots in one day. Just go to Nook, get your plot, give him the money, put the plot down somewhere outside, then go back to the town hall, talk to Nook, and you can do the process over and over again until you have all the plots built. I'm gonna go ahead and build another bridge just to be on the safe side to make sure the island is developed enough for KK Slider to visit. Now that I've placed these plots, I am gonna go ahead and make a little neighborhood area and decorate, because once the villager plots are all filled of villagers, the game is gonna want me to decorate. So I might as well just decorate now while I have everything empty so I can see better. So it looks like I currently have a 1-star rating for my island. Even though I've decorated a lot, I know this is because all the land I've sold is not full of villagers. The main goal is to all those plots. So to do this, you can either go villager hunting, you can scan in amiibo cards after you built the campsite. You can also invite villagers in boxes from other players' islands. Now I'm gonna go just fill those plots really quickly and I'll be back. So I've gone ahead and filled all my empty plots with villagers. So now I have 10 villagers living on my island. I have a maxed out island. So let's go see what Isabel says about the island evaluation. I'm guessing I will have a 3-star rating now. There is no way that with every villager filled and all this decorating that we're still at 1-star. All right, Isabel, tell us what we want to hear. 4 stars! We've gone beyond the 3 stars we've needed to get KK Slider. This is amazing. Honestly, if you're trying to get to a 5-star island, then you're already on your way. But for this video, we just needed 3 stars. You will know that you've hit the benchmark to get KK Slider when the evaluation is signed by KS, which stands for KK Slider. Tom Nook is gonna hear this, he's gonna freak out, he's gonna fangirl because he loves KK Slider, and they're gonna plan a visit. All you have to do to get him now is to go to the next day. If you have stuff you wanna do on the current day, you can go ahead and do that, just play a typical game of Animal Crossing. I'm gonna move on to the next day so we can finally see KK Slider in all of his glory. All right, the first thing you're gonna see when you load up the game on the next day is Isabel talking about Mr. KK Slider himself, how he's gonna put on performance, and then the game will automatically take you to KK's first performance on your island. You cannot skip this. This is technically the end of the tutorial, so you will see the credits roll, but this is not the end of Animal Crossing. You have just unlocked the main Animal Crossing game. So here we go, we're gonna enjoy a nice performance from KK Slider with all of our wonderful villagers in the audience. All right, I hope you enjoyed that performance of KK Slider. And Tom Nook will also give you the ability to start terraforming. You do unlock terraforming when you unlock KK Slider. Both KK Slider and terraforming get unlocked when you hit 3 stars. Again, this is just the beginning of the game. You made it through the entire tutorial, and now the world is your oyster. You can go ahead and really jump into Animal Crossing, really get into the game, what it's about. And I'm excited for you. I'm excited for everyone who gets to this point, because this is where the game starts. Now that KK Slider has performed, it's time to focus on making island life better and better. So thank you for watching this video. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions at all about getting KK Slider onto your island. I'll do my best to answer them. I just hope you enjoy the journey. Thank you for watching this video. Again, a huge thank you to Disney Emoji Blitz for sponsoring this video, and I'll see you in the next video.